What type of motorcycle should you get to get into adventure motorcycling? Hey, it's Danny Thompson. In this short video, I'm just going to give you a few of my thoughts about what type or style of motorcycle you might want to get into adventure motorcycle riding, motorcycle camping, things of that nature. So I kind of think about these types of motorcycles in like three categories. So there's the small scale dual sport motorcycles, what in my younger days we called an enduro. That would be like your 250s, your 300cc bikes. The Japanese bike manufacturers all seem to make something in this category that is gonna work great for a certain style of riding. The next tier up is your mid-level bikes, you know, your KLR 650, your DRZ 600, XR 650, bikes in that range. And then above that, you have your big adventure touring bikes, your GS, BMWs, your Tigers, you know, maybe an Africa Twin, the KTMs, things like that in that, you know, 800cc to 1200cc range. Now, all of these bikes are awesome for different things. And then that middle ground bike is kind of pretty good for all of those things. So one of the things that might help you determine which style of these bikes you might want to get is, where do you live and what's the type of riding that you're going to be doing? If you live in a more rural area where you can take back roads or just two-lane highways to get to camping sites or get to, you know, desert back roads, get to some good off-road areas, then those smaller dual sport enduro type bikes could work great. They can go on the highway 65, 70 miles an hour, and you could do it for a little while. It's not going to be very comfortable to do that for more than an hour or two, I would imagine. And it might not be the safest thing to try to do on a large four-lane freeway like in California, where everyone's going to be going 80 miles an hour. You don't have a lot of power to get out of the way, and you're going to get blown around a lot and feel a little vulnerable. But if you're not going to do that type of freeway riding, and you can go out your door, get on a two-lane highway at 50 miles an hour, some cool winding roads, get to the outback and be on dirt roads, and that's really what you want to do, then those smaller bikes are an amazing option for that, because once you do get off-road, those things are a lot of fun. They're easy to whip around. It's easier to control a bike like that than it is a large adventure touring bike is going to be off-road. Even though we see videos of guys doing it on the KTM 1200s and Tigers and the GSs doing gnarly stuff, those guys are great riders. I certainly can't do that. So that is definitely where you live and the type of riding you're going to be doing is something for you to really think about. Now, that middle layer of bike, like a KLR 650, that's what I had before my Tiger. The nice thing there is they kind of do it all. So a KLR 650, I've done 6 hours on the highway on it. It's not amazingly comfortable, but it's doable. And you can get a little more gnarly off-road with a bike like that than I can with my Tiger, which is a little bit bigger bike. So if you kind of need to do a little bit of both, something in that range might be a really good option for you. If you're going to be doing a lot of highway miles, primarily on the road, with just maybe going a little bit off-road on like fire roads and middle, you know, stuff like that, back roads that might be dirt or gravel, but you're not really doing like motocross desert riding or anything like that, then the big adventure touring bikes are amazing. If you're going to go on a long trip, you're going to go out for a week or a month, you're going to go around the country, you're going to be spending tons of time in the saddle, then the big adventure touring bikes is going to be the way to go. Now, obviously, from listening to this, it's no wonder that we all want more than one bike, or even maybe more than two bikes. So I love my Triumph Tiger. It is a very comfortable bike to ride for a long period of time. I can put some aggressive, more aggressive type of tires on it and do fire roads and things like that. But now where I live out in the desert, there's places I want to go that have deep sand, that are a little bit gnarlier, and a heavy bike like that, loaded with camping gear, it's going to be hard for me to ride in that condition. I know people that can do it, but I'm not at that level of rider. So I want to get a second bike, probably a DRZ 400 or something in that range, so I can get on the highway a little bit, but I can still whip that thing around a little bit out in the sand, get to some back roads, get to some campsites that would be tougher for me to get to on the Tiger. Where do you live? So for example, I up until recently had been living in a metropolitan area, and that meant that for me to get out to campsites I wanted to go to or cool areas to ride with great mountain roads, I was going to be in a couple hours of heavy four-lane freeway traffic type driving. So if you think that you're going to be doing long days in the saddle, then a larger adventure bike might be a better option for you. If you're primarily going to be on freeways, highways, things like that, having a bigger bike that's a little heavier, that's got more power to it, is going to make those long days in the saddle a little bit better. And if you're primarily only on the pavement and maybe only going off-road to fire roads and things like that, those kind of bikes work great for that, even if you're not a great off-road rider. Those are my thoughts. I'd be interested to hear what other people have to say about this. There's lots of great videos out there, kind of breaking down maybe more detailed differences between the different models within these categories. Dork in the Road's got a really good video about five best entry-level adventure touring, moto adventure touring bikes. So you might want to check that out. But I just wanted to put in my perspective of kind of like what my mindset is when I think about the type of riding that you might be doing and what type of bike might be great for that. All right, we'll talk to you later.